Hey, what is up, Nation? In this session, I'm going to be teaching you how you can pull contours from 3D terrain data using Sketchup. Okay, so I have Sketchup open here. This is Sketchup Pro 2018. Starting, I think, this year or maybe even last year, Sketchup has switched from Google Earth to something else. I forget what it's called. So this is a pro-only feature now. So if you want to grab a location, file, geolocation, go to add location. I'm not exactly sure how this works in previous versions of SketchUp, whether Google still works or not. I vaguely think that it doesn't work at all unless you have the pro version, so just be aware of that. And you can do this with any sort of 3D terrain model that you have. So we're going to choose, I can see all the topo here, so I'm just going to select a region. This region is too large. Okay, so you got to zoom in enough. There you go. So this looks like it's heavily topographic. I can visually see the topo. So we're going to select that. I'm going to hit grab. And it will import that area. You can see Digital Globe is who is doing that now, not Google. So when you go to File, Geolocation, Show Terrain, you can see that there's a lot of terrain going on here, which is good. So then what you want to do is you want to make a plane. So make a rectangle. I'm going to hit R here and make a plane on the blue axis. Just make sure that it's blue. This is larger than my terrain. That's fine. So I just want to pull this down, move it down. So I hit M, selected it, hit M, and then make sure that it's on the blue axis. You can always lock it to the blue axis by pressing the up arrow. That way, no matter where you are, it'll stay there. And then I'm just going to go. You can always sort of try to snap somewhere, so you may need to turn on hidden edges so you can see all the lines. And if your computer is fast enough, sometimes this can be a little tricky to get, but since it's a plane, you can select any point and it should work. So this looks like it might be like the lowest point. So I just moved it there. And then what you want to do is you want to use the multiply command that you can use in SketchUp. So what I'm going to do is you want to pick an increment. So typically contours are either like 2 feet, 5 feet, 10 feet, 20 feet, 100 feet. For this, it's very, and depending on the level of detail that you want in your contours, you'll decide based on that or how sloped it is. If it's a really low slope, but you want a lot of contour data, you want to have a lower number, but just make sure it's consistent. So I'm going to select this. And for this, I'm just going to say, let's do 5 and hit 5 feet. And you can see it's actually not very much. So visually, I may just want to do something different. So let's try doubling that. Go to 10. That's also too little. Let's try 100. That feels better. Just because this is so sloped that we're going to get a lot of information no matter what. So time. So I'm hitting the asterisk symbol here. 50. Now, it doesn't have to be 50, and you can actually change this number. If I go times 25, you can like reduce it until you get to a number that is better. So that was 15, so let's try 16. So 100 times 17. Okay, so there you go. So what I'm gonna do now is group these guys up. So they're all equally spaced at 100 feet per increment. I'm gonna make this a group. I'm gonna hit Control X. That's gonna cut that. And just to save some time on this, or my rendering time or computer speed time, I'm going to turn off hidden geometry so I don't see all those lines. I'm going to unlock this. I'm going to you can make a copy of it if you want. I'm not going to do that for this. I'm just going to go to edit group. Now you can go to paste in place and it'll paste all those little guys that we could just cut. And I'm going to hit select or control A to select all, and you can see that it will select all of this stuff. Now when I go to Intersect Faces with Selection, it's gonna take some time. Before you do that step, you wanna always make sure that you save because it depending on how many cuts you're going to make, it could take a long period of time and it could crash SketchUp. So just make sure you save before you do that. And you can see I have all the contours here. So, and they're all at the right height. So you may want to come in and delete these guys. So you just get the lines if that's what you want. A quick way to select this is to select it and hit all with same material. So you don't have to click each one and you can delete all of them. So again, I was selecting each one, but you can actually, because that texture is the same material, select one, right click, go to select, all with same material, delete it. And now you have your 3D contour data. Now you may want to flatten this. There's some flatten plugins you can use. I just go to 3D Warehouse and type flatten, and you should be able to do that. I actually don't think I have any installed at this moment. Here we go, flatten to plane. There we go. So I do. So that one's flat. But a lot of times when you get information from a surveyor or something, it'll be actually in three dimensions. So this isn't too bad for that. So hopefully this helped. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video with your friends. And as always, happy hacking.
All right, designers. Just because this episode of Designer Hacks is over doesn't mean we're leaving you out in the cold. Tony's got tons of great content available at designerhacks.com. So join Design Nation right now, and we'll see you on the next episode of Designer Hacks.